Hey, you know what I would like to do right now? I'd like to just start a new segment, A Minute with Greg.
No, look, what did you
say? I can give you a minute. That'd be about it.
I'd like to know what's on Greg's mind this morning.
Is anything chapping you today?
Well, I ain't going to say it because y'all really hate me, and I'm not going to do it.
No, go ahead.
I think it's inauguration's a waste of time.
I knew that was coming.
Same guy. It's the same guy. It's not a different person. Why? I mean, you know what I'm talking about? Why I go through all that? It's the same guy go, hey, that oath, you still on it. I'm serious.
It's not a change of power.
It's the same guy. He's seen all this 4 years ago. Yeah. It ain't new to him.
That oath, you're still on it.
Now, you know, he said well, the first one he can't remember. It's just all a big blur to
him.
He's enjoying this one.
Yeah, 4 years ago, we weren't sure he was president or not.
Well, now, that is a good point, Bill. Yeah. You're right. This one, he actually is confident that he did get elected.
Yeah, this was point. a little better victory.
But I'm not going to go deep into that because I don't want y'all throwing me off shell and we're going hunting.
No, that's a good point. I mean, it's not
same
a change
guy.
Of power.
It reminds me of the State of the Union address, which is another peeve of mine.
Yeah.
Why can't he just get up there and say, where we at, where we going, but we got to stop every 5 minutes and have his pep rally. Everybody stands up and claps. That is the most corny and stupidest thing. You can't tell me. They take something that should take about 30 minutes and put about 3 hours of television in it. Because I want you to keep up with the next time. They clap more than he talks. It's
that's
ridiculous.
True.
Well, now,
and half of them don't care. We just kissing butt, baby.
Well, now, if you look at
it's
this one.
It's the stupidest thing I've ever seen.
There's not going to be many
where
Democrats
we're at,
clapping.
And this is where we're going. Now clap as I leave.
Right.
As I'm blowing rump in your face. That's ridiculous.
So you can't,
I just hate the
you
process.
Can't clap to the rumps being thrown.
That's right. It ain't that I'm anti any Bush. I voted for George W. Bush. I'm proud to say it. It ain't that.
You just don't like.
I just
you don't
the
like
system.
Some of our. You
the
don't like some.
The process is corny and stupid.
You don't like some of our these ceremonial things we do.
Yeah, it's ridiculous to a point. I mean, we need a State of the Union address, and I appreciate it, but I can't watch it because I'm sick of watching everybody stand up and clap.
Right.
I mean, he can't say nothing. He won't even say nothing really that important, and we got to stand up and clap.
Well, it's
then
tough
you see
to
the
watch.
Ones that really don't want to clap, and they're standing up, and they got that stupid look on their face, and then they finally just quit standing up. It's just stupid. It's just corny and stupid.
It's hard to watch now because American Idol's on same time.
Right.
You know,
it
that's
is.
Tough.
I love
well,
that,
you know, Greg, and you're like this too a little bit, Bub, even though you do like some of the ceremonies because that's an emotional side of you. But,
right.
But,
no,
Greg.
I'm not when the Jets fly over, I get chills just like anybody
yeah,
else.
Yeah, that's awful. I'm talking. But let me tell you
yeah,
where.
Yeah, but I ball.
Let me tell you where
oh,
you.
It does. It, but I'm just saying.
Here's
you
where
watch
you
Reagan's
trim,
funeral?
We could trim the fat. Mm. When did it have it? If it was in the middle of the day, no.
Well, it was. It
I
went
saw
on,
highlights.
It went on for a week.
I saw highlights. You're right. Now they did bury him for about a month.
Yeah. How?
That's a little much. Too,
how come you weren't able to see it? How come you weren't able to see it?
Well, does it work?
Oh.
You know, I don't. Some of us don't get off at like 10 in the morning. Some of us just getting started.
That was a pretty big event.
Well, again, media. We're gonna talk about him dead for a month. I mean, I hate he died. And he was a great president, probably one of the greatest.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't think it's news every day.
Well, you know, Elvis would have been 70 something. His last birthday.
Yeah, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, how old was he when he died?
42.
That's how old he is.
That's as far as he made
that's it.
Or was it 52? How old was it?
That's where it ended. Well, I mean, they celebrate his birthday. It ain't his birthday. Guess what? He ain't here. He ain't got a birthday.
Those cease to exist.
If you ain't here to blow out the candles, you could go, he would have been.
Right.
If he would have, yeah,
yeah.
But he's not.
But how long do you even say that?
Yeah. Like I asked that question, which I thought you would appreciate. How long do we keep telling you how old he would have been? Do we get him to 200?
That's true.
You know, if we make it that long, Elvis would have been 181 today.
I
no, probably not.
Anniversary of his death, maybe just keep, you know, celebrating that. But as far as his birthday, I don't
did think you see where his songs are number one again in Britain? And now he's like doubled up the. Well, he's moved ahead of the Beatles.
That British charts.
Moved ahead of the Beatles in Britain.
Okay, who made the decision to put his records back in rotation on the – or is that how do they –
people
that,
who make jack off of it.
That would be the people who own the rights to them, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, but you know what I mean? These people own the rights here, but they're not going to put them back, you know, in – well, they did – what was that off of
remember when
Ocean's 11? They did redo one, and it actually went back – I don't know if it got on the charts, but you actually heard it on the radio.
But what I was telling the political front, where you and Greg are the same, but he's just an extreme version of it. You know what? He's got his king radar out. this old we make ourselves feel powerful and important when right. we're supposed to be run by the people. And you're like, too, we're not big on kings. And politicians, a lot of them, have forgotten that our whole government was based on we don't have kings anymore.
That's right.
And they like to be important.
We're having a very king-like ceremony today.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I think there needs to be some of that, but you definitely can overdo it.
I would like to see him get up there in front of that little podium he always gets on. They could give him his oath and then him go back to work.
Well, we know for sure 4 years from today he's headed home.
Right. Yeah. Sure.
And you can't say that about all the Congress, that's for sure.
Wow. Yeah, they'll hang around.
Oh, yeah. I mean, no, it's not. I'm big Bush supporter. It ain't that. It's the process.
I think they should play Elvis songs at the inauguration.
I do, too, especially since they're back top of the charts in Britain.
But do you think they can carry it too far the other way? I remember Jimmy Carter walking because of the gas shortage. I thought that looked kibbe. I thought that was kibbe.
I don't think I support stuff like that for 1 minute. Because you don't tell me that it was going to cripple the country if he drove.
Well, I know. That's what I'm saying.
No,
you can go too far the other way.
That's right. Back to ceremonial.
Please don't let me fall into that.
That's back to ceremonial. Because
he got in his limo and went home after the camera turned off.
Well, yeah.
You bet on that.
Well, sure.
So what's the point?
Right. Well, there's not one.
How about I'm the president, and if we have any gas left, I get to use it. That would have been my stance.
Wait, Greg, that's very king-like.
Well, it is. Yeah, I can't decide.
Really, I'm wrong. You just have an annoying meter.
Yeah. There's certain, listen.
You can go either way.
There's no agenda, but on each side, there's certain parts of it that bother me, but there's certain parts on each side I like, too.
Right.
There we go.
So you got to keep it between the ditches
right.
with Greg, basically.
Yeah, ain't no big deal.
Yeah. How do you like it at an awards banquet when, like, Kermit gets to bring us out an award?
No, what's better is when that guy that used to do, what was it, Madam?
Yeah.
And you can see him standing beside her and he's talking and they're acting like he's not.
Right.
I mean, he's out. He's not hiding.
I know.
He's operating the puppet talking for him.
Yeah, he's not even doing the ventriloquist thing.
That's right.
Now, we talked a little bit earlier about Scooby-Doo, the movie, and I know that you don't care for...
I've never seen it, by the way.
You don't like animated characters that are not there.
Yeah, they're interactive.
Well, I wouldn't watch The Hulk because of it. The movie The Hulk?
Yeah.
When I heard he was completely computer-generated, didn't watch it. Not if he was going. Now, if everybody else would have been computer-generated in the movie with him, that's fine.
Or if you'd had Lou Ferrigno making
right.
an
Or someone dressed as The Hulk.
Exactly. But no, I don't like interaction with not real and real.
All right. Well, I look forward. We're going to have quite an afternoon, it looks like.
That's right.
Join us on the next edition of the Rick and Bubba Show when you might hear Bill Bubba Bussy say,
"Look, Greg's animated."
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.